So this is the complete our project first sprint we started already. 9 days remaining. We have two user stories are there, and user story two we created a mini, and user story one is the user story one. So we have one user story. Under that there are subtasks, mini subtasks are there. So for each this we need to assign to some developer also, right? We need to assign to developer also. Let's assign this to, maybe we can so assign this first, this subtask I will assign. So who will, so what this subtask? So maybe you can add a description, all these things. Okay, add test cases for the register user, register. Okay. So then save it. You just click on that, it will know you can save the description. And then you have the labels. You can give a sprint one, sprint one. So label you can give sprint one. And here the all other four fields also you can see here. Sprint, you can give the sprint one, it is coming already, right? We can give labels, whatever the label you want, functional testing, something like that. And this is the tester. I'll assign to particular tester. So maybe I'll assign to Swarupa. Okay. Creating test cases. So then you have a components. We can say register component. Create a new component. You can say create a new component, or yeah. You can create a new component. So different. Register component. So component lead, we don't have, fine. Project is, so this is the project. You can give a project also, but a default project you can use that. You get the components also. When you go back, this component it will show. So under that, you click on this. So you can see the components also you can select here. So priority, how much priority you want, you can select a component, register component. So that's one component name. You can give fixed version, which version you want to queue, and maybe these are the versions. So we created a version, right? That version will come here. And then, so any estimates will be there. Priority is given. If you want, you can change the priority. So this highest to high, low, lowest to something like that. You can give medium priority also, right? It's up to you what you want it. Then save it. That's it. So then this is the complete. So task I assign to particular person. So and assign properly. Then review the test cases. Maybe review the test cases I'll assign to Swarupa. But no, Swarupa has written it, I'll assign to Shanti. So I assigned, and you are going to review the test cases. So the task is review the register test cases. Okay, so that, so I'll assign to you. So then other fields you can give estimations, original estimates. You can give here estimations. Maybe I'll give one story point. One story point means reviewing doesn't take much time, right? So that's why one, no, 1 minute or 1 hour, something will be there. 2 weeks, 4 days, 6 days, and 45 minutes, something like that you can give. So this is the, you can give maybe 1 day, or no, so even 1 day also it won't take, right? 6 hours I'll just put. Just put 6 hours. So that's enough. Or you don't need much on this. 6 hours also doesn't take, and 3 hours I'll keep. 3 hours. So 3 hours I'm giving for the review. So this is the estimation you have to do, right? Estimations you have to give, and the component is register component and fixed version. So this version you can choose. So that's a version you can do that, and that's enough. And that's it. And then
Sorry, this is how we report the bug in the template, you're saying, sir?
That's not a task. Task I assign what you want to do. The task I'm assigning, who will do this? The Scrum Master will do all these tasks we created, right, in the last class.
Yeah.
Those tasks I'm assigning to you guys.
Okay.
If the developer is there, developer task will assign to developer. So this is the one. For example, this one, smoke testing, who will perform, maybe Swarupa. I'll give that. So that's it.
Okay.
Three tasks I'm assigning to
person. Task for every person. Okay.
Every person. What you want to do. Execution also I'm giving for this. Let's do that. And then defect reporting also, you have to, this all who is executing, they have to do the things. So
the time given is to complete the task you need, the given.
Yeah, the estimation is for time given. So how much time you need to spend. That's our time. So the estimations are there, right? These estimations are, they will give here. In the sprint planning meeting, they will decide this, how much time you need for this. Okay, maybe I'll give 2 days for the regression and retesting. Like this, people will give estimation for each task. So this is the developer. So I'll just put my name as a developer so that I can work on these areas. So maybe one day I need for this designing. I'll just put that. So 1D means 1 day. Okay. So input. Like this, you can assign all the dev coding. The coding also, I will do that. But developer names will come here, okay, actually. So here we have 3 only, that's why I'm assigning accordingly. So this will take 5 days or, 5 days. I'm just giving 5 days. So 1 week. So it automatically taking 1 week, okay. And then unit testing also in the same pair only will come. And this sprint estimation will be done on the same, 2 hours I'm doing for this unit testing. So that's the build preparation is also done by developers only, so not by us. So that's the, we can give, it doesn't take much time, 2 hours task. You can give 2 hours task for this build preparation. And that's the task we create. Same way you create task for this second user story also. So then I can assign to so I can give, so I'll assign to this task, okay, but we have to create a task first for this. So story, we created a story, right? Maybe you can go to directly that, user story. You can open this user story and create a subtask. Again, same. So what is the subtask? Create a test case. So then review test cases. Then we have execute test cases. First perform smoke testing, right? Perform smoke testing. Then you can create execute test cases. And after executing, defect reporting, right? Defect reporting. So then retesting and regression testing. So these are all tasks created, or yourself you can create, or the Scrum Master will create. But your task you can create for each story. You can create your tasks, okay? So that's all, right? That's all these things I'll assign to these tasks to the Shanti. I'll assign, so prepare the test cases. So design the test cases for login, right? This is the login scenario. And labels, you can say simply sprint one label is there, you can use that label. Otherwise, you can just go here and select. So how many days you need? I'll just need 1 day to prepare the test cases. and then we have components. So we need to create a component, login component, or this one login component. Create a new component. The component means, you know, right, modules, right? It's just a module. So that modules. So like that, you can create a component. So that you can write the developer task also, you can add for this, right? So login, review the test cases. So that's the end of this. Review should be done by this one to Swarupa. So you prepare the test case, you should not review. So review the login test case. And then we have so the estimation, I'll just give 2 hours for the estimation. And then component is login component. So this is how we are going to create a components. Fixed version, so should be in the same version. They have to work on this. That's the thing. So perform smoke testing is done by Santi one. Yes, she is the owner for this thing. And then execute test cases also. So like this, we'll assign all the things. In this, everything you will work on the Jira only, it will be tracked all your what tasks you are performing. Everything will be tracked properly. So that you cannot escape and nobody escapes from here. So what is the status? How much work you are pending? If you are working, so that you we can put in the progress, in progress. You can drag and drop. I'll show you that out. The next step is, I'll show you that. Okay, all are assigned now, right? Assignment is done now. Now you started working. Now to do, right? To do task. First, you started working on that. You can put on this. So now next, Shanti started working on that test case reasoning. So you can drag and drop here. See, both are in progress. Now if you open this, it will show you in progress. It will show in progress. Automatically, it will show in progress. That status changed from to do list to in progress. So that's how you can move, keep moving into the different places. So that drag and drop here. Sorry?
Once it is done, we'll drag it to done.
Done. That's it. So there is one more will be there. Review thing will be there. So you can add a review also. Just I just want to board. You can add board to different components also. Open issues and expand also board settings I can do. So I want columns. Generally we have these things, right? Let me add columns. So columns. I can add more, right? You can write one more also. So you can set up add status, no, but we want add column. So I'll give review. So review we need, right? So yes. Review, we will add review. So in progress after review, then done all, right? Maybe you can add testing also, in test, so that also you can add. So it will come. You can create your own board, right? So that's how people will keep moving here and there and drag and drop. So then you can, so dev completed also you can put here. Dev completed, but not moved to testing. Say dev completed. So based on your, you can customize your columns, okay? You can customize, see that? So dev completed means it will come here. So not in testing, dev completed, but review, dev completed, you can put the review. So like this, you can move all of it. So that's the board. You can go to, so not this one, right? Projects. So one is the CSV system. See that all are going to show you now, right? So to do, in progress, dev completed, review, in testing, done. So finally, if it is done, you will move it to done. So these are the different status. Your task statuses, these are all. Your task statuses, these are all. Any questions? But these are all created by the admin. You don't need to do. You have this board, sprint board, right? This is the right board will be there. The project board will be there. When the first sprint starts, all will be in to-do list. Then they will assign. Once you start working, you will put in progress. Suppose you have completed, you will move it to review. Your test cases should not be dev completed, right?
Yes.
Developer will move into dev completed, but he will first move it in progress. In progress after dev completed, then put it in the review. Then they will move it to in testing. Then testing is done, they will move it to done.
So whatever the tester duties are there, only those columns we'll fill. Once we are done with the next column, we'll go to.
Review is common for everybody, developer and tester, right? Development code they will review, right? So in testing, when they will put, okay, they have completed coding and they deployed in the environment, the code.
Yeah, build is ready, then.
Build is ready, then only they can put in the in testing. Otherwise, they cannot keep it in testing.
Yes, sir.
But they haven't deployed, but they completed development. That's why they have, right? Dev complete this year. And review is done. Then you can put, or if you, for example, this, you want to move it here. You can move here and there. First review, then dev complete, they can put. That also you can do. And you can make the order this way also, whichever you want. So in testing means exactly the feature has come for testing.
Yeah, once the final draft is ready, build is.
So that's how you will move, and review of the test cases. So is going to be done. You are doing. You can put here. You are reviewing. You are doing. You put it in the review. Then your review is done. You can put it in the done. Your test case execution is done. You can put it here. Over. Right.
So. The done is like first testing is done, we'll put it there.
Create test cases is done, right? That's what.
Okay, create test cases is done only.
Review also done, you can put it here. Okay. Smoke testing is in progress, you are performing smoke testing. Just put it in the smoke testing is performing. So then you put no review here. If your smoke testing is done, then directly put in the in testing. If it is in progress, you put in the in progress, or you are not finished, then put in progress. If you are done in testing, you are doing in testing, you put and then move it to done. Go on. Like this, you can keep your executing. So you can keep in the execution. So execution in testing one. Then defect reporting, you are doing a defect reporting in testing only, that will come. And you are filing that, you can put in. So regression testing, you are in progress. So you are doing that. Because it's continuously, it will take some time, right? You'll file a lot of bugs and then you'll do a regression testing, retesting, all this will happen. So that will be in progress sometime. But the task hasn't finished, it will take a lot of time. That's why you'll put in progress. In progress means not finished. You're working on that. That time you can give in progress. Okay, and now that's a way you will work in the sprint. Every day you have a status meeting and you have to give your update. What you work, they can easily see here, right? They can also check and see them. Who are all the people, they'll check and they'll click on that. What is the task and their status of the task? You can track here itself. Where is your task also? They can easily check that. So that's the advantage of this. In progress and dev complete.
So everything regarding the project, everything is there in this. All the details are in this.
Exactly.
So these traceability matrix and all are not in this, right?
Traceability matrix?
It is not in this Jira. That is a separate.
No, that is a separate. Test cases you will create in the, for example, test case you created, you will add the test cases in the attach file. Because you will attach them, right?
Okay.
So you will attach them in the Excel sheet, you will attach them.
Yeah. So we'll create that and we'll attach it here when it is done. Okay.
Okay. Okay. So the next one is how to create a bug. This you flow, you understand this flow, right? Rupa and
yes, sir. I understand, sir.
So Shanti, any doubts?
No, sir. I understood.
So this is how you will work in the real time. The real flow and process, how we are going to work. That's why when you enter into the company, you should not feel that I didn't work on this, all these things. As it is, I'm showing you exactly. And you also practice this, okay?
So you want us to log in our own page or can we work on your...
Here only can work. You can move here and there, right? You can move back and you can do that. So I'll move back, okay? So you do that. Okay, everything you move back. So in the to-do list, I'll keep. And you can move back everything. And then you can so do that. You do that, everything, okay? It's your task. I assign to you. You are doing task. So you do that. Right? Okay. So that's the thing how we are going to work here. Now, last thing in the Jira, that is create a defect. So we created a story. We created a subtask for that stories. And I have shown you the workflow. This is called workflow. This is called workflow. How you will work will move till complete of that sprint. Sprint to how many days will go? 15 days. If they ask you, tell that. 15 days is the time period for my sprint. Then suppose if the sprint and you haven't finished the task, next what will happen? That task will move to next sprint. That is a sprint backlog so the backlog will be moved to next sprint. Then sprint 2 will start after 10 days, after 9 days. That's a sprint. Every sprint after you will, so the manager will, the scrum master will click on complete sprint, next sprint you will create. And the sprint 2 will start here. And again, same procedure. The workflow is same. Again, sprint 2, new features they will take up. Right? When they created a sprint, they will add the user stories. That's sprint 2. User stories again, task you will create and continuous process this one. It's just a continuous process, right? So that is the how the workflow will be in the Jira tool. Any questions?
No. Basically, sprint is the time within the time frame we need to do some user cases, user stories. We need to do some user stories.
So that user story is a requirement, madam. The user story is going to work both the development and testing team.
Okay. If the tasks given in that sprint should be completed.
Completed.
If not, the task will go back to the backlog again.
Next sprint, which next is sprint. Called sprint backlog.
Hmm. Sprint backlog. It will move to next sprint.
Okay.
But it's not spillover. You have to work. You should not But if there is a blockers, you can do that. But if there is no blockers, then you cannot do that.
Okay.
The time for each sprint is 2 weeks, 15 days.
Generally 2 weeks only. Okay?
Okay.
Now, let's see. Next one is how to create a bug in the... Suppose you assume that a small bug will be there. So, I'll say 404. One bug is there. I'll just show you that bug. So that it will be easy for us to understand that how to file the bug. You got a bug, okay? Okay, you can join again. So basically the meeting is going to after, if meeting ends, you can join. Otherwise you can see that. Okay, now we got it. So this is the one. If you click on this link, you're getting a bug. 404 page number. You need to file a bug. How can you file a bug? So just click on, anytime you want to file a bug, click on create. So create, and the project name will come. The store issue type, you should select to bug, okay? Bug you select, and summary. So click on, so the link name is, so this is the link name, create a new sheet in existing. So this this link, and it is throwing a, create, click on create link, throws 404 error page. That's a summary. The components where you got, you can write the component. Okay, the components you can just put maybe in the login page you got somewhere, right? Wherever you want, you can choose the components and you write. So on clicking some link. Okay, this is not a valid. I'm just putting here. It's not relevant to this login, but I'm just showing a sample. Not for error page. How you got steps to reproduce? Write steps to reproduce. Then you can say, open the URL in Chrome browser or whatever the browser. The URL you. What is the URL? So not this one. This URL. Can just give this URL. Just give this, and then can say click on this link in that homepage. So then, what is happening? Actual result. The actual result means what is the application behavior? So application throws 404 error page. So expect the result. So link homepage to this homepage. Create new, so Java link homepage should be displayed. Okay, so that's it. You can add all the screenshots of fixed version. We know fixed version, right? That's this is the version. You can choose priority, so high priority I'm giving. Labels, what are the labels you want to create? Functional testing. You can create functional testing. So environment, you can give testing environment. And Chrome browser. So you need to mention all these things. Any attachment, screenshot there, you can add a screenshot. Now this is a screenshot, right? So you take a PRTSC click from the keyboard. Can you see PRTSC in the keyboard? So you click on that. You click, and this belongs to which one? So this relates to, you can give a login, right? Login related. So the you can give the story number. The story number you can give. What is the story? And the story is login, right? You can give that story. So that story you can mention. Automatic, assignee to automatic. Epic, if you want, you can add epic also. So which epic? This is epic. It belongs to that epic. The sprint, you can mention all the relevant data you can choose. And click on create. The bug will be created. So that you will get a bug. So the bug is created. So see that this is the bug. SS23 is the bug. So this bug will be shown to you. So this is the details you can see. So all the details you can see like this. So this is how to fill the bug and this description, all the things. And you can assign to particular developer. So I'm assigning to developer. If you know the developer, you can assign to developer. And then they will take care of all these things. If they required anything, you file the bug and you add it. So you give the information. If they request any information, you provide it here. Okay? See that this bug belongs to this user story, and you can write that. That's how to file the bug. This is the project name and the bug ID. SS23, this is a bug ID. So this bug ID you will mention in the test case document. There is a bug ID column, right, in the test case document. There you will mention this. So this is how to work with them. Any bug, and you have the lot of stories will be there. So this is the bug ID you will mention to in the meetings also. You take up all the bugs. What are the bugs you filed? You note down somewhere, right? Then it will be easier. Even though you can search them, okay? See that you have a search option filter. It will show what are all the bugs you filed. It will show here. View all filters, you can go and it will show all the bugs. Filters, you can see. You can see the bugs also. This is the bugs and task it will show you. This is the filter for search option will be there. For any tool, you have a search option. You can search also. Okay? So this is how we are going to work in the Jira. The bug means in the red color, it will be there. Bug means it will be there in the red color. That's all about the Jira. Any questions?
No, sir.
No, sir.
So you're right. That's all about the Jira. How we are going to work with Jira. Now, So let's understand ALM tool. There is a ALM tool will be there. What is this ALM? Another project management tool, right? Another project management tool. And that is same as a Jira, that also. There you can write your test cases. You can execute them. You can report the defects. Even many people will use that story, that again, that tool. So that ALM tool can be used by many people, right? So that tool is called now ALM, Application Lifecycle Management Tool. Application Lifecycle Management Tool. So we'll see that tool. Maybe this is finishing in the next 2 minutes. I don't want to waste here. We will rejoin again, okay? So we'll rejoin so that